consciousness is one of these great vexing and confusing words and concepts, which, you know, intelligent people take different positions on it and could argue about forever. My own perspective on consciousness is rooted in what you could call a sort of panpsychism, by which I mean the idea that consciousness is, in essence, a property immanent in existence, much as space and time are. I mean, everything that we see around us somehow is situated in time and in space, in our space-time continuum. Panpsychism is the idea that everything around us and within us has some, you know, element of consciousness to it also, so that it's not really meaningful to think of, you know, here's this non-conscious matter, and then there's this thing called consciousness, which is attached to some matter and not to others. Now, panpsychism, to me, is not even that interesting. It's almost obvious. It's just the foundation and the beginning for thinking about consciousness, because then you have interesting questions like, you know, why is the consciousness associated with my brain so much more, you know, self-reflective and, you know, dynamic and in some senses intense than, say, the consciousness associated with my hat, right? I mean, that the hat, it's a cool hat. It may be more conscious than the average hat, but I mean, in the end, the brain has these complex feedback loops. The brain can model itself. The brain responds very differently to slightly different stimuli coming in. And many properties of the brain seem associated with the, you know, the more powerful and dynamic states of consciousness that it has relative to other things. So if you accept panpsychism, that everything is imbued somehow with an element of consciousness, you know, some things can still be more conscious than others, and some things are differently conscious than others. And then that's where things get interesting, right? When you talk about AI, so I would imagine if I were able to, you know, tap a wire into my brain or Wi-Fi connection into my brain and wire my brain into your brain, then as I increase the bandwidth of that wire between my brain and your brain, I would feel your mind there, like on the fringe of my mind, like almost as if we were fusing into one shared mind or something. And that would be a bit freakish, could be a lot of fun. But on the other hand, if I took my mind and wired it into my hat, like I might feel what it is to be a hat, but I would imagine whatever consciousness I feel on the other end of the wire, it's not going to be quite the same as melding my mind with the mind of another human, right? It's going to be melding my mind with something that doesn't change very much or have much variety to its state. On the other hand, what if we think of, you know, Sophia version 10.0 with her mind enhanced by the Singularity Net blockchain-based AGI mind cloud, right? What if I wire my brain into that? Does it feel like wiring my brain into a human brain? Does it feel like wiring my brain into a hat or a brick or an earthworm, right? So these will be very interesting experiments to do. And they're even scientific in the sense that they could be audited by the community. Like if I wired my brain into my hat and then I said, well, I don't feel too much of the hat's consciousness there, just a little, you could wire your brain into that wire and then like view what is the fused state of myself and the hat, right? Or if I wired my brain into Super Sophia and I said, wow, that's a really intense state of consciousness. Now I feel what it's like to be a robot. And it's amazing. You've got sensors all over the globe. It's like a DMT trip to the 10th power, right? You could wire your brain into that wire and like look in on that subjectively and think, well, yeah, I can feel on the fringes of my consciousness, like, yeah, there's Ben and some, you know, Sophia Singularity Net supermind, which are fusing together in an intensely conscious way. So this is what I think of as second person science, right? Because it's a little different than just first person experience that others can't audit except indirectly through words or pictures or something. It's also different than typical third person science where you're concerned with spreadsheets of numbers that are read out from the dials of experiments and so forth, right? It's sort of scientific community-based auditing of shared experience among different entities. And I think this is going to unfold in the next decades as brain-computer interfacing and brain-brain interfacing technology mature beyond their current significant but still early stage. And this is probably how we're going to really crack the nut of consciousness and see, you know, in what sense does panpsychism make sense, and what sense are humans differently conscious than different types of computer systems and so forth.